Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to all of you. How are you all doing, grade one? Good. That's very great. Yes, I'm also good. Alhamdulillah. Thank you. And welcome to your numeracy class, right? Okay. So from today onwards, we have started, mashallah, week 15 of our classes. And in all of these 15 weeks, we have covered a lot of topics, and every topic was different from the previous one, right? So we have practiced a huge variety of things from the mathematics, and including the four number operations. We started with the basics of counting. We also discussed ascending and descending order. We talked about the number operations. We talked about how we can find out the missing numbers. We talked about the role of number line in finding the missing numbers, right? And many, right? So, and the last unit that we have covered was about the measurements, right? And the measurements include, let's say, how we can compare two things. We talked about comparisons. We talked about the comparative degrees of adjectives, right? Then let's say if two things are different, how we can make a comparison between the two. And the topic that we have, or the unit that we have started in the last week, is money. So we introduced each other first with the money. Then I showed you the different banknotes and coins that we have in Pakistan. We talked about that. Then we also talked about what is currency and what is the name of Pakistani currency. So who is going to tell me what is the name of Pakistani currency? It's rupees. Excellent. Okay. And then we also talked about that. I showed you different coins, different notes, which we have, right? Now in today's class, the topic we will be doing is that what are the different ways of making rupees 10? Okay. So in order to understand that, or in order to discuss few ways through which we can make 10, we will be starting with how many coins do we have? So who is going to tell me how many coins do we have in Pakistani currency? Yes. Raise your hands. Okay, very well done. Everybody is raising. This means that all of you know, right? Okay, so let's listen to Vase. Yes, Vase, how many coins do we have? 5. Okay, good. Can you identify them? Coin of 1 rupees, coin of 2 rupees, coin of 5 rupees, coin of 10 rupees, and coin of 20 rupees. So we have total of 5 coins, right? Okay. And in between, we don't have a coin of 3 rupees, we don't have a coin of 4 rupees, we don't have a coin of 7 rupees, right? But if we want to make them, we make it through the combination of others, right? Let's say you do not have, okay, if we make a list of the coins that we have, how many coins do we have? A coin of 1 rupees. Beside that, we have a coin of 2 rupees. We have a coin of 5 rupees. Then 10 rupees. And finally, 20, right? We have only these 5 coins. So now what should we do if I want to buy something which is of 3 rupees? What should I do? What should I do if I want to buy something which is of 7 rupees? What should I do if we want to buy something which is of 9 rupees? But we don't have coin for them. We don't have notes for them, right? So how will we buy that? For that, we will make a combination of something. Let's say if I want to buy something of 3 rupees, what I can do, I can have one coin of 1 rupees plus 2 rupees. 2 plus 1 equals 3. So if I have these two coins, I can buy this thing, right? Similarly, let's say if I want to buy something which is of 9 rupees, what I can do, I can take one coin of 5 rupees and two coins of 2 rupees. And I can have the thing which is of 9 rupees, right? This does not mean that if I don't have the coin of 9 rupees, I cannot buy anything with that, right? So why we are starting in today's lecture, but why we are studying different ways of making 10? Well, the effort or the reason behind that is that let's say the amount for which we do not have a coin or a note, for that, how we can make different combinations. So when you will practice this, you will be able to make other different combinations as well. Got it? Okay. So let's, instead of practicing with 10, who is going to tell me if I want to buy something of 7 rupees, what would be the combinations for that? See, I have these coins in my hand. So if I want to buy something which is of 7 rupees, I'll be needing one coin of 5 rupees. This is a 5 rupees coin, and the second coin of 2 rupees. So if I have these two coins, I can buy the thing which is of 7 rupees, right? Other way can be that I can have 3 coins of 2 rupees and 1 coin of 1 rupees. This also sum up, when we sum up this, it turns to 7. Are you understanding my point? Let me write it for you. Look at the board. If I want to make 7 rupees, the first combination is 1 of 5 rupees and the other of 2 rupees. 5 plus 2 equals 7, right? The other way can be that 3 coins of 2 rupees and 1 coin of 1 rupees. This also makes 7. The third can be that I take 7 coins of 1 rupees. This also makes 7, right? So I have these 3 different ways through which I can make a 7 rupees, right? Through these combinations, I can buy the thing which is of 7 rupees. Now let's say if I talk about the 9 rupees. So for 9, how many combinations we can make? The first one was that we take a coin of 5 rupees and 2 coins of 2 rupees. This sums up and give us 9 rupees. The other combination can be that I take 1 coin of 5 rupees and 4 coins of 1 rupees. This also makes 9, right? The other combination can be that I take all coins of 1 rupees, 9 coins of 1 rupees. This will also make 9 rupees. See? 1 rupees plus 1 rupees plus 1 rupees plus 1 plus 1. So this is how we make combinations. Now, because you have learned this all, now we will be moving toward our today's topic, that is that how we can make 10. So we will be learning about different ways of making 10, okay? Are you guys excited? Is this interesting activity? Okay, so now you will be telling me that how we can make 10. Okay, over here, I'm making a list of the coins that we already have so that it will be easy for you to make the combinations, okay? These are the 5 coins that we already have. And whatever the combination that we will be making by using these coins, right? Okay. And what we want to make, we are supposed to make 10, okay? So the first combination I'm going to tell you, the first one is 5 rupees plus 5 rupees. If we have 2 5 rupees coin, it will turn to 10. Let me show you that as well. Here I have 2 5 rupees coin. See? 1 and 2. If I have these 2 coins, this 5 plus 5 adds and make a 10 rupees, right? This is the first combination. Can you think of any other combination? Come on, hurry up. Very well done, Elise. The second combination can be that we have 1 coin of 5 rupees and other 5 coins of 1 rupees. See, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 and 1. So 1 coin of 5 rupees and 5 coins of 1 rupees. Very well done. Everybody clap for Elise. Very good, Elise. Okay, who is going to tell us the next combination? There is another, okay, let me give you the hint. There is another combination with the 5 rupees coin. Yes. 5 plus 2 rupees plus 2 rupees plus 1 rupees. This is the third combination. And let me show you that as well. This is 1 coin of 5 rupees. Okay. This is the coin of 2 rupees. Then I have another of 2 rupees. 5 plus 4, 9 plus 1, 10. So these 4 coins together make a 10 rupees. Got it? Okay. Let's talk about the next combination. So the next combination can be that we have 1 coin of 5 rupees instead of this, right? If I write it as 1 rupees प्लस 1 रुपीज, प्लस 2 रुपीज, प्लस 1 रुपीज. Now see, this is not similar to this one because in this one we have all of 1 rupees. Over here we have added one of 2 rupees. So these are different. Okay, don't get confused with it. Okay, we are done with the combinations which are meant with 5 rupees coin, right? Now let's move forward. What can be the other combinations? These 4 are done. Okay, let's look at the other ones. The other combinations can be, let's say the first one could be, okay, this would not be the first one, this would be the fifth one, right? That 5 coins of 2 rupees plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. 5 coins of 2 rupees also make a total of 10. So this is the 5th combination, right? Let's look at the 6th one. 6th one can be that we take 10 coins of 1 rupees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have taken 10 coins of 1 rupees. This is another combination, right? Okay, can you think of any other combination? Hurry up. We are done with 6 combinations. Okay, let me give you the hint. We can make 4 more combinations. Okay, I want all of you to please open your book, page number 72. This is page number 72. Please open it. This is the topic that we are doing today. And the statement says that in how many different ways can we use coins to make rupees 10? Let's look at the combinations. How many of them we have done already? We are done with this one, 2 of 5 rupees, right? We are done with this one, 5 of 5 2 rupees coins. We are done with this one, 10 1 rupees coin. We are done with this one, 2 1 5 rupees coin, 2 2 rupees coin, and 1 1 rupees coin, right? I showed it to you as well. Okay, we are done with this as well, that 5 1 5 rupees coin and 5 1 rupees coin. We are done with this as well. Let's look at this one. 1 5 rupees coin, 1 2 rupees, and 3 1s. This is also done. Let's move forward. We are not done with this one. Okay, let's look at this. We have 4 2 rupees coins and 2 1 rupees coins. This is the 7th combination, right? Let's look at the next one. The next one says that we have 2 2 rupees coins and 4 1 rupees coins. This is not 4, basically we will be having 6 1 rupees coins, right? This will also make a 10. Well, the next can be that we have 2 2 rupees coins and remaining would be 6, right? We are done with that. And the last can be that we have 1 2 rupees coins and remaining 8 of 1 rupees. Done? Was this interesting? Okay, now in your book, the coins are mentioned. You are supposed to tell their number. Let's say you have how many 5 rupees coins are there? 2. So just write number 2 over here, right? Look at the next one. How many 1 rupees coin are over here? 10. So write number 10 over here. Count the number of coins and write the number before it. Hurry up. Do it and share it with me that what are the numbers that you have written. Okay? Hurry up. All of you are done? Okay, tell me what are the numbers you have written. How many 2 rupees coins? 5. Excellent. 1, 2 and 1. Very well done. What about this one? 1 and 5. Excellent, Elise. What about this one? Yes, Abdullah, you tell me. 1, 1, 3. Very well done. Look at the next one. Sara, you tell me. 4 and 2. Excellent. Look at the next one. 3 and 4. Okay, let's move forward. 2 and 6. Very well done. And look at the last one. How many 2 rupees coin? 1. How many 1 rupees coin? 8. Excellent. Okay. So do you guys enjoyed the lecture? Wonderful. Now, what is your home assignment? You are supposed to find different ways of making 15. Your home assignment is that you are supposed to learn, or you are supposed to find out different ways of making 15. Just do it at your home and share it with me in tomorrow's class, inshallah. Before doing the next topic, I'll be having a look at your different ways and we will discuss it together. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed the lecture. Do practice it at your home and share this video with others because it's free learning. I'll be seeing you in the next class. Take care. Allah Hafiz.